Welcome friends, in this video we will discuss about various types of gas based power plants. Basically we can segregate our gas based power plants into three major categories. First one is simple cycle gas power plant, second type is closed cycle gas power plant CCGP, and the third one is combined cycle power plant CCPP. Basically in a simple cycle gas power plant, that is SCGP, it is a type of natural gas power plant that uses a single turbine to burn natural gases and produces electricity. In a gas turbine, basically the chemical energy of fuel is converted into electrical energy. If we talk about its major components, the major components of a simple cycle gas power plant are air compressor, fuel gas combustion chamber, and then gas turbine. Friends, we all know that for burning fire, we need fuel, air and heat. Basically heat is in the form of some ignition spark, and as a result of burning of fuel, flue gases are produced. Friends, we have ample amount of air available in our environment. Air is taken through air intake into our air compressor. Here the air compressors are axial type of air compressors. The pressure of air is increased, keeping the temperature constant. As the temperature is not changing, so this type of process is called isentropic compression. Also, as there is no transfer of heat or mass between the system and environment, so this compression is also called adiabatic compression. And as a result of this compression, the pressure of the system increases and volume decreases. So same is traced on the pressure versus volume graph here. From point A to point B, we can see as a result of this compression, the system pressure is increased from atmospheric pressure to a higher pressure at compressor exit. Next, this compressed air goes to combustion chamber. Here the fuel gas mixes with this air, and the fuel air mixture is ignited with spark. This combustion is done keeping the pressure constant. The combustion product is flue gases. And as a result of this combustion, there is an increase in volume. So same is traced on this pressure versus volume graph from point B to point C. We can see that pressure is constant, but the volume is increasing. Next, these flue gases are then passed through the turbine blades. The turbine blades are mounted on rotor shaft. As the flue gases strike the turbine blades, the shaft starts rotating. These blades are in multiple stages to utilize the optimum energy of flue gases and to rotate the shaft with sufficient speed and torque to generate electricity in the generator. As the flue gases passes through the blades, the gases expand, thereby increasing the volume, and also their temperature decreases. So same is traced on this pressure versus volume graph from point C to point D. We can see that pressure is decreasing, but the volume is increasing. Finally, the exhaust flue gases are vented to the atmosphere through stack, thereby bringing the system pressure back to the atmospheric pressure. We can again look at our graph here. At point D to point A, the exhaust gases are vented to the atmosphere and the system is coming back to the atmospheric pressure. So this complete cycle from point A to point B, point B to point C, and C to D, and D to A. Basically A to B is air compression, the pressure, system pressure is increasing. B to C, fuel gas combustion chamber, fuel gas is burnt, keeping the pressure constant. Then point C to point D, the flue gases produced as a result of burning of the fuel are used to rotate the blades. And when this, it passes through the multiple stages of the blades, the flue gases expand, the system volume increases, but the pressure decreases, that is from point C to point D, and from point D to point A, the exhaust gases are released to the atmosphere, bringing back the system to atmospheric pressure. So this complete cycle is called Brayton cycle, and gas turbine basically operates on Brayton cycle. If we talk about the advantages, the simple cycle gas power plant is very simple in design. It has a very lower cost as compared to closed cycle and combined cycle power plant. and as the number of components are very less, so it requires very less space. The main advantage is their faster startup time to reach its full capacity, and due to this faster startup time, it is very useful to cater peak load requirements. Generally in power plants where daily start and daily stop is required, in those power plants it's very much useful. Basically, such kind of power plants are not required to operate continuously, but are required to assist during peak load requirements. And if we talk about their disadvantage, friends, we discussed that here we are converting the fuel gas energy, basically the chemical energy contained in the fuel, into heat energy in the combustion chamber. Then that is converted into mechanical energy to rotate the blades, and that rotating shaft generates electricity. So fuel gas energy is getting converted into electrical energy. But finally, the exhaust gases are vented to the atmosphere. These exhaust gases are still at a very high temperature and pressure. So only approximately 30 to 40% of chemical energy of fuel is converted into electricity. Rest all is wasted. So a simple gas, simple cycle gas power plant is having very poor efficiency of only 30%, or at max up to 40%. So friends, we already discussed that a simple open cycle gas power plant is having a very poor efficiency of 30 to 40%, because most of the energy is wasted to the atmosphere. So there should be some way to utilize that energy, but those exhaust gases, we cannot feed back those exhaust gases into the compressor again. So as a solution, these closed cycle gas power plants are designed. Here, instead of rotating the turbine blades with exhaust gases, we have working fluid, and these working fluid are not coming in direct contact with the exhaust, these flue gases. If we talk about its major components, the major components of a closed cycle gas power plant are compressor, then heater, then gas turbine, and finally a cooler. Here basically the difference is, earlier we were compressing the air, but in this case we can have working fluid as air, helium, carbon dioxide, or nitrogen. First we compress this working fluid in the compressor. Then this compressed working fluid is passed through the heater tubes in the heat exchanger. So working fluid is inside the tubes in this heater, and outside the tubes we have a fuel air mixture that is burnt, and heat is produced. That heat which is outside the tubes heats this compressed working fluid, and then this compressed and heated working fluid is then passed to the gas turbine. Here, when this compressed heated working fluid strikes the turbine blades, it rotates the turbine blades, the turbine shaft is rotated, and finally electricity is produced. Now the exhaust fluid, instead of venting to the atmosphere, now this is routed to the second heat exchanger, and in this case the heat exchanger acts as a cooler. The exhaust fluid is allowed to pass through the cooler tubes, and outside these tubes cooling water is circulated. Thus the heat is transferred from exhaust fluid to the cooling water. This way the fluid temperature is reduced to make it suitable for recompression in the compressor. Friends, got it? It means it is a closed cycle. First working fluid is compressed in the compressor, then it is heated by the heat of fuel air mixture, then this working fluid rotates the turbine blades, which is connected to turbine rotor, that produces electricity in the generator, and then exhaust fluid is again cooled down in the cooler, and then it is again recycled in the compressor to compress again. So complete closed cycle. As the fluid circulates in closed loop, this type of power plant is called closed cycle gas power plant, CCGP. Advantages are closed cycle power plants are more efficient because they can operate at higher pressure and lower temperature, and the used gases have better thermodynamic properties. These power plants have a better part load behavior. Next is the combined cycle power plant, CCPP. Friends, we have already discussed simple open cycle gas power plant based on Brayton cycle. The exhaust gas carries a lot of energy unused and vented to the atmosphere. In combined cycle power plant, this unused heat energy is used to produce steam and rotate the steam turbine blades and thus produce electricity. Basically, a combined cycle power plant consists of two thermodynamic systems, one for the gas turbine operation, that is the Brayton cycle, and second thermodynamic system is for steam turbine operation, that is called Rankine cycle. If we talk about its major components, then on gas turbine side, it's air compressor, then fuel gas combustion chamber, then gas turbine. This part we have already discussed in the simple open cycle. While on the steam turbine side, it's heat recovery steam generator, then steam turbine and condenser. The flue gases from the gas turbine exhaust are passed through this heat recovery steam generator, basically the HRSG. The HRSG consists of many, basically hundreds of water carrying tubes. And outside the tubes, these hot exhaust flue gases are passed. Thus, the water gets heated and converted into superheated steam. This superheated steam is then used to rotate the steam turbine blades, which is connected to generator rotor shaft, and electricity is produced. Basically what is done is these tubes, water is there, outside exhaust gases from gas turbine are there. The tubes are getting heated, so water is boiled, and this water rises, the steam rises up, and above we can see steam drums are there. Here this steam is collected, and lower side it's water, upper side it's steam. So from top side of these drums, the steam is extracted, then it is again superheated to make it suitable for steam turbine entry, so that it should not contain any water particles now. Otherwise, it could cause corrosion in the of the turbine blades. Then this superheated steam is passed to the steam turbine blades. The turbine blades rotates and electricity is produced. And the exhaust steam, after rotating the turbine blades, is cooled to condensate foam. This condensate is dumped into the condenser, and this condensate is recirculated in the loop again using pumps to produce steam. So basically, it's again a closed cycle. Water is entered into the system once, and then that water is heated to produce steam. That steam rotates the blade, the turbine blades. Rotating turbine blades is connected to rotor shaft that produces electricity in the generator. Then this exhaust steam is condensed and that and collected in the condenser. From condenser, it is again pumped back to the drums. So, but due to any leakage or any loss of water, that is compensated by demineralized water. On the flue gas side, the exhaust gases are transferring heat to the HRSG tube through various stages of the HRSG. In this process, they have most of the energy is utilized in the HRSG. Also, we take care of the hazardous gases like SOx and NOx, which are not good for our environment. So those gases are removed before venting out the remaining flue gases to the atmosphere through HRSG stack. Friends, here no additional fuel is used in steam turbine. Only the exhaust flue gas of gas turbine is used. Thus, with the same fuel, additional electricity is produced. If we talk about its overall efficiency, the overall efficiency of combined cycle power plant is thus increased to approximately 60%. Coming to its advantages, as we have already discussed, no additional fuel gas is required. The fuel gas is only fed to the in the Brayton cycle to rotate the gas turbine. So no additional fuel gas is required. With the same fuel energy, extra electricity is produced. So these kind of power plants have a higher efficiency, approximately 60%. And as the exhaust gases are already cooled, so it would be lesser pollution. If we talk about their disadvantage, so higher initial building cost, then number of components are more, so higher space is required, and in this cycle water is required to produce steam, so need more water to produce electricity. Friends, I hope I am able to clear the concept well. In our next session, we will discuss in detail about the combined cycle power plant, especially the Rankine cycle, with including our steam turbine, HRSG, and balance of plant. That is our complete water steam cycle. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.